The 19th of March is National Poultry Day. Did you know that 70% of all birds are poultry and that 75% of all land-reared animals are chickens? In fact, there are 3 chickens for every human on Earth. They're not just a global protein source. This is an internationally important animal. Hi everyone, my name is Bushra Abu-Helil. I'm a PhD student in Arjun Narbad's group at the Quadram Institute Biosciences on the Norwich Research Park. My project is focused on poultry intestinal health and welfare. Although my initial work is going to be focused on broilers, so the chickens specifically used for meat production, I'm interested in applying my research to benefit a multitude of poultry species. I've always been an animal lover. I told my family back when I was 7 that I wanted to be a zoologist. After my undergraduate in 2015 in zoology, I was a bit disheartened by academia, so decided to leave formal education and immediately started working at the Wellcome Sanger Institute as an animal technician. My enthusiasm for academic research quickly returned, and I then progressed to becoming an associate scientist for Cancer Research UK, looking at immune-oncology drug targets. But chickens were always my destiny. I've kept chickens from a very young age. I even used to have an incubator in my kitchen during high school so that I could continue to breed them. So when this project came up, I immediately saw the potential impact it could have on an international scale. Due to global concerns of antimicrobial resistance, back in 2006, the European Union banned the use of antimicrobial growth promoters in the feed of livestock animals. The mechanism of this was unclear, but it was thought to suppress the microbiome to allow a greater uptake of nutrients by the animals. When this was removed, the poultry industry saw a 5% reduction in their productivity. There was also increased incidences relating to gut health, such as necrotic enteritis and dysbacteriosis. Traditional microbiology techniques were only yielding around 5% of the microbiome. So by implementing new methods, such as next generation sequencing, we can look at the DNA of all microorganisms within the intestinal tract. I'm really keen to be linking the microbiome to the immune system and also to productivity. I'm especially interested in using the feces of the birds, and that's because it's so easily accessible. It doesn't really stress the animal out to collect it, and it's a non-invasive technique, so again, a real focus on welfare. I'm really honoured to be doing this work at the Quadram Institute Biosciences because Norfolk is such a hub for poultry farming. I really hope that my work can continue to help us appreciate the importance of welfare and the impact it can have on poultry productivity.